Boris never fitted into town. In Novgorod, they'd always worn a frown. For 300 years and 3 billion tears. But Boris's mouth turned up instead of down. It was on Russian art to be sad and suspicious if you didn't feel too bad. He was happy as a lad and was followed around by Vlad to find out why he always felt so glad. He was Boris, the happy Russian, was probably resulting from concussion. He was afflicted at birth by an overdose of mirth. He was Boris, the happy Russian. KGB, they frisked him for bugs. He reacted by giving them all hugs. He found Chekov hilarious, with a thrill almost vicarious, and wasn't drunk or taking any drugs. He giggled like a drain when he lost money, thought Groucho's brother Carl was just as funny. He didn't know his birthday, but was raised, so they say, by the tiniest babushka Easter bunny. He was Boris, the happy Russian, probably resulting from concussion. He was afflicted at birth by an overdose of mirth. He was Boris, the happy Russian. They interrogated him in Gorky Park. He fell asleep as they tried to frighten him in the dark. And the mafia had no success, cause he poked fun at the way they dress. And they had no comeback for his sarcastic remarks. His left leg was much shorter than his right, which meant he walked in circles day and night. The circles got so small one day, he met himself coming the other way and was too confused to put up any fight. Sometimes Russians have to laugh to keep warm in winter. Oh, Boris was a sucker for bluegrass. He thought that all sad music was a farce. It only made him bored, and he wouldn't know a minor chord if it jumped up and bit him on the ass. He was Boris, the happy Russian, probably resulting from concussion. He was afflicted at birth by an overdose of mirth. He was Boris, the happy Russian.
Thank you.